glory to the Father, to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit, as it was in the beginning, now and ever shall be, world without end.
So also we see Matthew Gospel, chapter 4, verse 17. Jesus began to proclaim, "Repent, for the kingdom of God has come near." That's a today's reading. We have read Luke, chapter 8, verse 1, proclaiming and bringing the good news. Jesus has come into this world to proclaim the kingdom of God. The gist of his proclamation and preaching was the kingdom of God. Therefore, we must know what is the kingdom of God. Yesterday is our classes, our social person was dealing with that subject. He was explaining in different levels. Nutshell, as a gist, as a definition, St. Paul gives what is the kingdom of God. And to Romans 14, chapter 17, verse says, "For the kingdom of God is not food and drink, but righteousness and peace and joy in the Holy Spirit." Righteousness and peace and joy. We have to understand in a better way the meaning of the kingdom of God. We have to differentiate the earthly kingdom as well as the kingdom of God. When we reflect over the earthly kingdom, depends on the base. It is territory centered, whereas kingdom of God is beyond territory. Each state is divided and has own territory. And also each life is bifurcated or divided and it has own territory. Secondly, the earthly kingdom is centered on matter. Matter centered or material centered. Whereas kingdom of God is person centered. Kingdom of earthly kingdom is profit oriented. Whereas the kingdom of God is sacrifice oriented. Earthly kingdom selfish-centered, whereas the kingdom of God is other-centered. Again, I will enumerate so all of the examples also, but you take that, therefore I am giving the summary of it. The earthly kingdom is centered on money-centered, whereas the kingdom of God is love, peace, justice-centered. Earthly kingdom is giving the attitude to accumulate the things, to accumulate money and accumulate what all things you need to go on increasing our needs. Whereas the kingdom of God is calling on to share. So the central kingdom of God is sharing. Therefore Jesus gave his life on the cross for the welfare of the human being and the salvation of this world. Every kingdom is power centered, whereas the kingdom of God is service centered. Therefore, dear brothers and sisters, when we analyze these things, Jesus was proclaiming the kingdom of God. During that time, we see the disciples were there. Particularly in this gospel, we read They were also human. They were accompanying the disciples and Jesus. And their attitude, we see their attitude. Several others who provided for them out of their own resources. Those were the characteristics, the attitude and the mentality of the human and discipleship of their conflict and confrontations and the controversial things. The human can be a priest, the priest can be given to human also. But the attitude and the characteristics of the kingdom of God, you could find these human disciples. Yesterday, after one of the lunch, one of the sisters here came to me and asked me, "Father, you are 11, but one father is not here. No one felt that one father was not here for the lunch, but that sister failed. And with the absence of that priest, and this he was asking me." This is the tangible issue that the women who were during the preaching at the gospel provided for them out of their own resources. The sisters may also have more like that, but she had that compassion, that only she said, that she didn't know what is happening. Therefore, I also already knew that what is action, because he is from our synagogue. Therefore, I want to be able to ask my father, I'm not feeling well, because I don't need to eat lunch. Then I told my sister, then only she was quiet. Even then, she was not satisfied. Father, I will be in the room. If anything new, I will ask. Therefore, dear father and sisters, the disciples, the human disciples, who provided for them out of their own resources. We can cite some examples, but concretely, we can experience this kind of attitude. Therefore, men and women are called to be the disciples and provide the kingdom of God. Human provided for them out of their own resources. In the understanding of the church, they say, "Poor in your Yesha, not Jesha, Gaksha." That is, there is no salvation outside the church. That mentality church can tell you. But now, poor in your language with me, not Jesha, Gaksha. Out of the kingdom of God, there is no salvation, which means kingdom of God includes all the religion and all the people beyond race and class and everything. Therefore, we also preach the kingdom of God and also practice in our day-to-day life the values of the kingdom of God. Let us ask the grace so that He may send His Spirit upon us to do His. Thank you.
God looks to the human vulnerability. There's a difference in good and good, the reward. Thank you, God, for a bad word. Because that's a different thing. God is making use of the Lord. At the same time, the ecological is speaking how the wholeness of the world is.
Therefore, we are conditioned by our culture, by our faith.
One simple example is this: what we call this hospital example, immorality, lying with another woman. Naturally, in our culture, that is very, very wrong. But they say,